What's happening, YouTube? It's been a little bit since I did a video, and you know, first of all, I want to thank all my new subscribers. Just awesome, guys. Thank you so much. I've got a ton of new subscribers, so let me take you guys around the shop a little bit. And you know, a lot of my loyal followers, they already know about the shop and have seen a bunch of stuff, but let me show you around a little bit here, guys. This is my man cave, and we'll just start over here. And I've got my scrap box of metal down there, and I've got steel down here. I've got my Dremel 4000. I've got my Kydex press, hammer, ear protection. Got some belts down there. I keep all my handle materials over in here. Got a ton of different handle materials. And take you over to the workbench here. And there's the drill press. The old 1x30. Oh, here, guys, check this out. I don't know if you guys remember a while ago, I had broken my DeWalt grinder. And my buddy Scott over at the Lion's Den. What's up, Scott? He was kind enough to send me out a DeWalt grinder that he was not using. And how awesome is that, guys? I mean, that's a heavy item. It's an older model. It's actually a lot different to cut with than the one I've been using. But nonetheless, it's really nice to have, you know, as a backup. I'm actually still using my broken one. I kind of fixed it up, and so anyways, I want to thank you, Scott. And I've got here the second part of the batch, new batch of mini skinners. There's about 8 of them here. I've got a batch of 12 of them that are over at Peter's. So, pretty excited about that. The mini skinners have been a real good seller. So, let me show you guys what I got going on the bench here. First thing is if you go back through my vids, you'll see that I make a couple bushcraft knives. This is a full-size bushcraft knife, 0.228 thick and 5160. And this one is reserved for Artisan Tony. And it's nice. Really, really digging them. This is a 5160 finished bushcraft blade. I've made a few of them. This one here I'm keeping. I made this handle just for my hand. And gotta get a leather sheath made for it. But put a Scandi grind on it and convexed it. So I do a Scandi Vex grind, which gives you the best of both worlds, in my opinion. It gives you strength, sharpness, and it's just unbelievable. And especially with Peter's heat treat and the deep cryogenic quench, just awesome. I love Peter's. Those guys are just amazing over there. Okay, what do I got going on the bench here? A couple things here, and this is for my fellow German friend. This is a heat treated N690 PCK, personal chore knife. And I was going to finish this up and just sharpen it. It's pretty thin, Udo. But I know you like to modify stuff, so I'm going to send this out like it is. And I think you'll really dig it. I got a really good grind on there. Nice and even. And also in that package is... this is one that I had made a long, long time ago. It's a tiny little knife. Just profiled it out. It's N680 nitrogen steel. Kind of screwed up the holes there a little bit. But this goes in the package to Udo. And this blank here is for Andy Haas. So that's going to be pretty cool. See what Andy comes up with there. And check this out. This is for Scott H. Brother, the grind on this. This is my original EDC blade. And this grind is looking real nice. This is going to be headed off to heat treat with that other batch of mini skinners. Just got that looking real good. Got a real nice grind. I know you wanted a little bit of a higher grind on that. Man, is this nice. I'd love to keep this one here, man. It's looking real nice. Nice and even. Kind of feathered those grinds in a little bit right there. Looking real good, man. You're going to be really, really pleased with this. Man, is this a nice knife. 5160, and this is a beast. 0.226 thick, I believe. Man, I love it. Really happy with the way the grind came out on this. Really, really happy. You're going to be very pleased with this, Scott. Scott H. Man, does that look nice. Ready for heat treat. Okay, on to the next one. The new knife model, the Ultra Skinner. Check it out, guys. This is the Proto in S30V. And man, does it look good. This is basically a modified mini skinner. I made the tip. I made it a little bit longer here. Upswept slightly with a thumb ramp. And so I wanted to give you guys a good look of what these are gonna look like. And I'm gonna keep this as a template. I think the grind just came out real nice. Getting the hang of this Grizzly. I've only had it for like 3 months or something, but really getting the hang of it. So yeah, this is the Ultra Skinner, and these are all going to be in D2. Looking real nice. Okay, moving on. This is just a basic EDC knife that I'm going to be making. And this is also the first proto, or the template. And I'll be keeping this one here. Not sure what steel I'm going to be using on these yet. Just going to be a real nice... You can see the size of it. It's be a real nice EDC blade. Like I say, I'm really getting the hang of the grizzly and getting the grinds real nice. Let's see if you can see. Also got one profiled out in 5160. Same thing. It's kind of like the mini Skinner, only with a big jet, with a lot bigger belly. See, if you look at, go back through my videos, look at the mini Skinners, you can see they're pointier. This is one that I cut out with Scott's angle grinder he sent me. But you can see next to it, the top one has a lot more belly, whereas the mini Skinners are—they're not as wide and they're a little pointier. Whereas this one here, the EDC, has a lot more belly, more of a, basically, you know, made for more tasks, whereas the mini Skinner is really an excellent Skinner. You know, Ray over at Wild Wilderness, his that I made, I have a video back there, a few vids back, he quartered an elk, skinned 5 beavers, 2 coyotes, before he had to, all he did was strop it. And it is paper shaven, push cut, and sharp. What's up, Ray? Let's see what else I got going here on the bench. Oh, the AEBL Classics. I do have a couple of those left. These are heat treated blanks. Okay, and you can see one finished. I've shown this in a video before. This one's got chestnut diamond wood with coyote brown liners, stainless tubes, and these are in AEBL. I get my steel from Alpha Knife Supply. They sell AEBL in 0.136 thick. And I just love AEBL. It's super, super sharp. So, I love cutting paper. I'm addicted to cutting paper, guys. And I was going to sell this one, but I'm in love with it. Absolutely in love with it. And let's see what else I got going here, guys. This is one I had made for myself. I have the baby bushcraft, baby woodchucks. And these are the full size. These are 9.5 inches, almost 10 inches overall length. And the baby woodchucks are 6. Let me measure real quick here, guys. The baby woodchucks are just about, no, they're exactly 6.5 inches long. And this one here is a heat-treated blank, and this is going to a special friend of mine here on YouTube. And I'm going to finish this one up here as soon as I turn off the camera. And I'll probably do a special video on that. Not too sure. Maybe just send it out and surprise. But in any event, I had made myself a baby woodchuck, and I have been testing the hell out of this thing. And let's see, I've got her all scratched up, and it has been holding up extremely well. I'm very, very happy with it. Does any tests I want to do. And it's remained sharp. I have not done anything but strop one time. Yeah, it's remained very, 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 very nice and sharp. So I'm real happy with the baby woodchuck. Stout blade. Real nice and stout. So this is by my own personal user. See, I've got it in a Hunter Orange Kydex. A little Schmuckatelli bead on the end there. It's got the black and OD green layered G10 with the Hunter Orange liners. Yeah, I've been wearing this a lot. I wear it on my belt. So, yeah, it's been wanting to test it out, and it's been, I don't know, maybe a month now, a little bit less, and I'm really, really happy with that. So, I'm real confident in these baby woodchucks. There's a bushcraft blade, all around woods blade. Very, very happy. What else, guys? Oh, Joe. Check it out, brother. My buddy Joe's Neon. The PCK, okay? And I talked to Joe about this, but Joe, I got the belts in there for you. And then also, I'm going to send Joe out a heat-treated baby woodchuck blank, and we'll see how Joe does with it. So that's coming your way, brother. And of course the PCK, love it. Joe, you're gonna love this. It's an N690. Of course it's sharp. Can't do enough sharpness tests for you, Joe. Let's see. I haven't touched this thing, but make sure she's still sharp for you. Yes. Very sharp, Joe. Gonna love it, man. It's gonna be a killer neck knife. Nice sheath for you. Yeah, that's going out, Joe, tomorrow. And what else, guys? All my new subs. Thanks again, guys. A little look around the shop here for you. Here's one of my favorites. The Rising Skull, I call this. Damascus blade. And this is just an accident, but it looks like a rising skull coming out of that Damascus. And this is for my buddy GTG. It's got thin red liners. I etched the pins. It's got black G10. And I absolutely love this blade. I could never part with it. Really, really nice. Super sharp. This thing, I have never touched it. Look at that. All the way down. One of my favorites. Absolutely love it. So yeah, I know I haven't done a video in a while, guys. I know the video is going to be a little bit long here, but yeah, I haven't talked to you guys in a while. I'm really enjoying everybody's video. Where'd that sheath go for? There it is. Really enjoying watching everyone's videos, and I apologize. I haven't done a video in a while. Just life kind of gets in the way sometimes, you know, guys. But, oh yeah, I was showing you around the shop. There's some cool stuff. Looks like I got some Rusty's rags up there. There's some belts from the old 1x30 hanging on a rack. Temperature up there. Oh, check this out, guys. Scott over at the Lion's Den. A while back, he had made me a video showcasing my channel. And he sent me a DVD of it. How cool is that? And up here, I've got some handle materials. Some more handle materials. Here's some beautiful, beautiful. Let's see if you can see that. Stabilized black palm. Look at that stuff from Jake. Beautiful Jake. Love it, brother. I'm gonna save that for something special. Wonder if that'll fit on my Oh, here's a project, guys, that I was making myself for Christmas. This is a CTS PD1, not BD1, but PD1 from Alpha Knife Supply. And I wonder if this will fit on there. Yeah, baby. Oh yeah, that black palm will fit on there real nice. That's gonna be sweet. So yeah, I would never sell this here. This is PD1 is very hard to find. And man, is this gonna be a nice one here. 8 inches overall length. And my style is very simplistic. You can see. I really do love. See, it is curved here slightly. And it's got a little bit of curves in here. Almost a choil. But man, is that going to be nice with that palm. Wow. That's going to be sweet. So that's just kind of a personal project. Oh, I still have my full-size woodchuck. I also offer those in N690, guys. Of course, they're more money because N690 is probably at least double the price of 5160. Although 5160 is an awesome, awesome steel, especially for a larger blade. And like this one here for Scott H, I consider this a larger blade. Man, Scott, let me know how you like this. I really, really like this one here. I really love the way the grind came out. I think it just looks excellent. What a great EDC blade that's going to make for you, man. Do all kinds of stuff with that. That's about it, guys. Trying to think what else I forgot. Well, that's it for now, guys. So yeah, I've got mini skinners at Heat Treat. Got another batch cut out. And the Ultra Skinner. Oh man, is that going to be sweet. So I'm going to be offering these guys. The Ultra. Ultra Skinner. Like I said, really getting the hang of this Grizzly. So let me know what you guys think. A lot of info there, a lot of stuff there on the bench, and this one's special, and you know who you are. I'll probably do a special video on this one. This one's done, I think, or just send it out and surprise you. But it's a baby woodchuck. Of course, guys, and all my new subs, in case you don't know, all my blades are heat treated and deep cryogenic quench over at Peter's. And I have a video up, guys, of a shop tour of Peter's Heat Treat. And it is just awesome. Those guys are amazing. That cryogenic chamber that they built, minus 312 degrees, I think it is. And, you know, the cryo. Nothing touches the... It goes off of the vapors. It's just amazing. And if you Google cryogenic treatment on blades, you'll see how beneficial it is to knives. So, and it's kind of nice. I don't have to worry about it. I can get a nice lean grind on them before I send them to heat treat. So, alright guys, that's kind of a quick update, a lot of information. Hopefully you guys stuck with me the whole video. I'm going on 27 damn minutes. And I will talk to you guys real soon. Peace. Peace, Gonzo. Later.